Well, I think health information technology is touching every aspect of modern healthcare delivery. And it touches all of our physicians, it touches the folks who interact with patients on a day-to-day basis, it touches hospital administrators. And I think that folks who are skilled in leadership and informatics are really going to be in an excellent position moving forward to lead healthcare delivery, because healthcare innovation in the next 5 or 10 years is going to be underpinned by health informatics. And I think we're trying to train a student population that understands the technology and the information that we get out of all of these new electronic health record systems, how to analyze all that information to ultimately improve care and improve the health of a population. I think it's all about the balance. It's the balance between the managerial aspects of what it takes to lead a health IT delivery organization, balanced with some of the technical aspects of what it means to be an informatician. And it's that balance that comes across so clearly in MMCI, and I think that's a unique difference that MMCI students have over traditional informatics students. Traditionally, informatics students study informatics, study the science of informatics, but miss out on some of the management aspects of their learning. And MMCI brings those two together. And so if you're looking to be a CIO, a CMIO, a physician executive responsible for the delivery of health IT, MMCI gives you the parts and pieces that you need to have a rounded base in order to do that. So I learn something every day I teach in an MMCI class. I learn from each and every student in that class. They come from heterogeneous backgrounds, they all bring something different to the table, and I think that's something that's unique. You have folks who are technology focused, you have folks who are clinicians or clinicians in training, you have folks who are out in biotech and pharma industry, who all come together and bring their unique perspective to the conversation. So it's a dynamic learning environment where I'm leading conversations and helping people get the core knowledge in informatics, but I'm also learning from the entire class, because they all bring different perspectives and different ways of thinking about things. So I teach data information and knowledge representation. And I think that the strategic differentiator for the health systems in the future is going to be how we use all the data that we're collecting as part of this EHR. As part of meaningful use, ERA and HITECH, these federal laws that basically say every hospital and health system around the country has to have an electronic health record. The byproduct of that is that we're all going to have this technology in place. We're all going to be generating enormous amounts of data about who our patients are, what kinds of diseases and conditions they have, what treatments work and don't work. And I think that the real benefit in the future is going to be using all that information, doing the right analytics, having the right health intelligence tools, to understand what that means from a population perspective. I think healthcare is changing. It's less about taking care of one patient at a time and more about taking care of a population of patients and understanding the trends within that population so that we can better improve the care of the entire community we serve. Well, we're at a critical crossroad. A road where our ability to gather and store electronic information has outpaced our ability to use that information to take care of patients. And I think that one of the key benefits of the MMCI program is being embedded in the clinical environment, embedded in the operations, understanding how hospitals and health systems work and think, and understanding how we can use all this data that we're generating to improve those operations. And that's really what it's all about. That's going to be what differentiates us in the future, is how we use our data to improve the care that we deliver. And that's best aligned, I think, with the School of Medicine and the health system here at Duke. You know, I think return on investment is traditionally thought of as dollars and cents. I think it's actually a twofold issue that we're trying to address. One is return on investment, the other is what I call return on health. Return on investment is really about, we're spending millions of dollars on EHR technology. How can we be more efficient, more effective in the way that we're using our resources to take care of patients to ultimately have a better value proposition post the electronic health record? Return on health is really about, how do we use this new technology to take better care of patients than we ever had before? We have all the data in one place. We can exchange the data through the health information exchange with other sites around the country. We have health analytics that we can place on top of the data to understand where we have opportunities to improve. All of those things come together into this concept of return on health, our ability to take better care of a population of patients with the same resources or fewer resources than we ever had before. And I think that's really part of the value proposition. So when we started our EHR work here at Duke, we created a benefits realization group. And that benefits realization group started measuring metrics even before we went live with the EHR so that we can understand and study the impact of the electronic health record over time. And we've had some great examples of where this has been very successful in generating traditional ROI as well as return on health. It's probably one of the most exciting things I do in my job. I think that we have a responsibility to train the next generation of health IT leaders. I think that Duke is a leading academic medical center, and it's part of our role as a leading academic medical center to really share our knowledge and build folks who can be the future health IT leaders of tomorrow. And what I love about it is, again, everyone brings their own perception, their own perspective to class. And so I feel like I learn as much as I teach in these classes. And that's really the value, is that the education you get through the open dialogues and discussions about difficult topics that everyone around the country is dealing with brings tremendous value to the students. They learn from their peers, they learn from their instructors, and it all comes together in a program that I think is molding the future health IT leaders of tomorrow.